Alright, so it's done the exercise. And open R Studio. So what I'm going to do here is look at a log likelihood plot first. Okay. So let's look at values to the evaluated map. Okay. So what is this doing here? It's x values. Everyone downloaded the function? Okay. Yep. Exactly. Yep, we're choosing sequence. Good. Okay. Now I'm going to do a plot where the x is that value and the y uses dnorm. So we know what dnorm is, it's a function. Normal distribution. Okay. So R has lots of models built in. Okay. Among them, normal distribution, binomial, exponential, log normal, beta distribution, gamma. So many things built in. All of them have like a D norm, a P norm, or D beta, that sort of thing. So this is the density plot. This is probably a density function. That's what we're using here. So delete the Y limit, apologies for that. Look at this log likelihood curve. Okay, we're doing it in log space. Okay, so in many cases with phylogenetics, the probabilities we're dealing with are very low. All right, so what does you know, just enter a particular value. Okay. So, d norm of 0.1, mean equals 0, st equals 4. What does that mean? What am I doing there? We'll look at what the arguments for dnorm are. Right, so mean for normal distribution, SD is standard deviation from normal distribution, right? I'm evaluating it at 0.1. Right, so what does the probability density function give you? And, you know, for continuous variables, I could look at the PDF of, you know, from 0.1 to 0.2 and get, you know, probably landing in that space, right? If it were a discrete function, discrete value, like, you know, binomial, Probably having exactly two heads out of three flips. Right. But this one's a little different, but basically that. Right. Good. So plotting this, what does this mean? What are you getting from my plot? Right, so let's get our different values. Just like when we had our coin flipping example, right? And we had those curves. Right, let's get our different values of probability of heads. Same thing here, but now it's four numbers. Now, in file genetics in general, we often do a logarithmic space, and in general, we often use logarithmic space. Okay? Because probabilities can get very, very, very small. Okay? So imagine, what's the probability of having exactly, you know, A here, G here, T here, C here, for thousands of bases across dozens of species? Under any model, it's going to be pretty low. Right? Imagine we just took nucleotide at random. We have it for all species. It'd be 1/4 times 1/4 times 1/4 times 1/4 times 1/4. So 1/4 to the number of sites. Right? Not only the best case where all species are the same. Right? So these numbers get very, very, very small. And it's too small for your computer to store. And so if that happens, if you're doing it in log space instead, it's a lot easier to store it. Right? So for R, for example, so this number is twice that number, right? R saying you're equal. Right? I can't handle precision that small. Okay. Now if we're doing log space instead, we could handle that. Okay. And so we're looking at, you know, probably of trees, this can get very, very very, very tiny numbers. Right? And so this isn't just an R thing. C has this issue. Anything that has finite precision has this issue. Okay. and so by doing log space, we don't deal. It's what we get. It works better. Okay, so I have people like looking out. Okay. Right. Okay. And we can do the same. So here. Alright, sorry, I told you before it was working fine. Let's move on. Move on to here. Okay. Let's go just the coin flipping example. I'll come back to it a little later. Alright. So let's imagine we have a space where we have three models only. Okay? The coin can be 0.1 heads, 0.5 heads, or 0.8 heads. Okay, that's our entire universe of hypotheses. Okay. What I need to do is figure out what could be your prior on the hypothesis. We have three hypotheses. What do you put out on the priors? What would those be? Okay. Some more different prior. We can manage different fires, right? We'll be a flat fire for this. No, what would be an unformed fire? True, except that the prior has to sum to one. Right? This is a probability. So it'd be 1/3 for all. That'd be a flat. And we normalize later. So if people aren't good at doing the post subtraction thing, fixes that. So I'm put 5, 20, and 2 would correctly make it all sum to 1. Okay. So with a flat prior, you should say each hypothesis is equally likely. No, but it's saying for my given coin, there are three models for how that coin will behave. One model, and so this is a little artificial example because, of course, it's a continuous parameter. Right, imagine we have, you know, person A, person B, and person C, so these are my hypotheses. Right, one person says it's 0.1, one person says it's 0.5, one person says it's 0.8. How do you now include priors in the hypotheses? And so why might you want to do a flat prior for this? Say it again? Not really. So this isn't so the sort of like null rejection thing isn't really a Bayesian framework. We just have different ideas we're comparing. Right. So they don't know anything, so all hypotheses are equally likely. Right? Why might you want to have a non-flat prior? Right, so we say, okay, person B here has a pretty good idea. Right? You might say, hey, you know, person A is my advisor, so I put 0.95 on hers. Right? I mean, different ways you can come up with priors. You should have some justification for why you want the prior you did. Okay, so you have a prior here. Right. So we put these in. Okay. Now we get 2/3 heads on our flips. So the number of flips total is 3. The number of heads we get is 2. Okay. Why do you think I'm doing it this way? We have round. Well, the flexibility later, right? So if I make it later, I want to do, you know, 30 flips or 31 flips, right? 31 times 2/3 is not an integer, right? And so for the models later, it might throw an error, right? So what I need to do, I need to round this with proper data. All right, that's something for you to figure out. You can figure this out in pairs or in groups. How do you talk about your likelihood for each hypothesis for these data? Did you have it?
I think you showed us before where rounds
Oh yeah.
Does that have to do with this at all?
No. I mean that could affect this. Yeah, you guess you could. That'd be freaky. Yeah. Like you could have 1.5 and 2.5. Well, it'll still have some 4. It'd be 2.5. It would be round both round to 2. No, round to, it doesn't always round up.
No, I mean that's how like I was.
Right. That's not how it actually rounds. Yeah, I'm not sure. I mean, it's a long-standing standard for computer code, but I'm not sure why it is that way. But you're right, that would fix that issue of always rounding up. Yeah. Okay, so what are people, how are people trying to figure this out? Okay.